Hi, I'm Dave Long from StaticWorx, and today we're going to talk about my favorite topic, static dissipative versus conductive. Probably the biggest question we're asked by any client for the first time when they call is, which material should I use? Should I use static dissipative flooring or should I use conductive flooring? The short answer is neither. You should be quantifying what you're buying. You shouldn't be buying based on a description. But let's go through it. That way you'll have the same understanding that I do. What I've done here is I've drawn a simple line chart starting at zero and going up to a billion. And what I'm going to be plotting here are what we call ohms. Ohms is the unit of measurement that we use to determine how conductive a material is. Ohms is a property that allows us to predict how rapidly we can eliminate static going through one of our floors. So what I'm actually telling you is that if a floor has 0 ohms, it's very, very, very conductive, like a puddle of water, stainless steel, copper. If a floor has 1 billion ohms, it's like the carpet in your living room. 1 billion ohms is so many ohms that anything over that amount, the floor is not going to have the ability to eliminate static at all. So what we need to do is find the sweet spot, that place where the conductivity is just right that allows the floor to prevent static, ground static, and keep you safe so that you're not grounded so close to the earth that if you touch an electrical circuit, you're going to get a shock. One of the problems with reading specification sheets is inconsistencies in how they quantify materials. What you'll see sometimes on a spec sheet is an ohms rating of 10 to the 4th to 10 to the 6th. People call me all the time and say, what does that mean? If you go back and look at your mathematics from high school, you'll remember that 10,000 is the same thing as 10 to the 4th place, 4 decimals away from zero. 10 to the 5th is 100,000. 10 to the 6th is 1 million. So when you see these numbers, you can either look at them as exponents, or you can look at them as actual values. But so let's take a look at how we can plot this out. Right now, if you look up a definition for static dissipative, that definition will tell you that any material from 1 million ohms to 1 billion ohms is called static dissipative. If you look up the definition of conductive flooring, you'll determine that any floor that has a resistance of 1 million ohms or less, and by the way, they don't specify the low number, anything from 1 million ohms or less is static conductive. Well, right now we've got two choices, something that goes all the way down to zero and something that goes all the way up to a point where it's so not conductive that it won't get rid of static electricity. So how do we know which material to use? Well, fortunately, we have other standards. One of the standards we have is called ANSI 2020. And this is one you should write down because anytime you write a spec, that's what you want to look at. ANSI 2020 says that the floor and the person together should have a resistance of less than 35 million ohms. Well, 35 million ohms is somewhere in between 10 million and 100 million. So let's call it right here. And let's use the green marker and we'll say that that's the highest point of resistance we can have. The NFPA and OSHA say that the floor has to have always more resistance than 25,000 ohms. Well, here's 10,000, here's 100, so here's 25,000. So in between here and here, we have the lowest margin where you're still safe. We have the highest margin where the floor will meet this ANSI 2020. So we've essentially eliminated a big portion of the static dissipative range, and we've eliminated a big portion of the conductive range. But if you notice, we're in between the two. We're saying that some of static dissipative is adequate and some of conductive is adequate. So that's why when somebody asks me, which material should I get, static dissipative or conductive, my answer is, don't use either term. Specify exactly what the properties of the floor should be, and those properties should be more than 25,000 ohms and less than 35 million ohms. Now, I have one thing to add. Statistically speaking, would you really want something that's right at the edge of safety? Most people will tell you they don't want that, because what if some other conditions allow the floor to be a little more conductive? Maybe it gets wet. Maybe the installation circumstances are such that it drops the conductivity down because of some pre-existing condition. So what we look at is a little bit of margin of error. We like to use 100,000 ohms as our minimum resistance. So when we talk about a floor that's going to be safe but still work, what we're talking about is a floor that will measure between 100,000 ohms and 35 million ohms. What I would suggest, if you want to know more, go to our website, go to the Knowledge and Safety Center, and read some of the articles on floor testing, read some of the articles on the proper conductivity for grounding. Don't just end it here. This is just the beginning. And of course, you have the ability to pick up the phone anytime you want and call me at 1-888-STATICWORX.